we stand and say,
I'm giving up.
on. You said keep our business on the road. I'm just trying to get out of the friend zone. Cause you look even better in the photo. I can't find your house, send me the info. Driving through the gated residential. I'm not always coming, send your friends home. Keep on trying to hide it, but your friends know. I only call you when it's two bitches, all I got you. So you're gonna have to do it at the tempo. Always trying to send me off to rehab. Drugs just started feeling like a thief. I'm just trying to live here for the moment. All these motherfuckers wanna relapse. I only call you when it's has passed by. Sorry, we got some fucking patriots in the house tonight. Fucking A, New Hampshire. Live free or die! A lot of people forgot about that saying. I didn't forget. I didn't forget. We got any veterans in the house today? Hey, put your hand up if you served this fucking country. Hey, somebody buy these motherfuckers a drink. Thank you guys very much for fucking Al Freedom. Thank you for fucking making a sacrifice that gives us the opportunity to come and play stages in a country where I can say whatever the fuck I want and not go to jail yet. Right? They haven't, communism hasn't got us yet. And we're gonna play some fucking songs today. We're gonna have a good time. We got Struggle fucking Jennings in the house. Make some noise. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to say that this is the only tour in the United States that every single venue that we are playing have abolished the mask and the fucking vaccine mandate. It's your body, it's your choice. If you're vaccinated, that's cool. If you're not, that's cool too. I don't give a fuck what your religion is, what your medical shit says. I don't care if you're whatever your gender is. All I give a shit about is that you're a good fucking person and you obey the law and you do the best that you can with your fucking life, because that's what this country was founded on and that's why we're here. Ladies and gentlemen, can I get a let's go, Brandon? This song is called Killing Me Slowly.
I'm so hot and it's killing me.
You guys having a good time? Have we all seen each other before? Y'all seen me? Anybody here for the first time? Anybody here for the second time? Thank you for coming back and welcome to all the new Jacks. Appreciate you guys being here. Three times? Hell yeah, brother. All right. Well, things are a little different now. I love you too. Look at that. There's so much love in the house. Hey, we're shooting music videos on this fucking tour. Because this is kind of a fucking historical thing that we're doing. This is because the fucking tour is not going by the CDC guidelines or the World Health Organization. So, for everybody who's new, I'm going to need some fucking crowd participation. So I want to see everybody get down real quick. Do me a favor, everybody get down on one knee. Not like Colin Kaepernick, when it's not going to be like that. It's going to be way cooler. Did you guys see the new... I want a fucking Netflix special. I'll tell you right now. I want to fucking be sent, I want to be enslaved by the NFL. It's crazy. These people are fucking insane. You got a dude who's making a show, trying to show that football players are like slaves. And I'm like, the last time I checked, if I took a time machine to visit my ancestors, I don't think any of the slaves got paid fucking multi-million dollar contracts to go pick cotton. I'm sorry, bro. I don't buy it. I'm sorry. Anyway, everybody get down. I'm going to count to three. I want to see everybody jump up and scream as loud as you fucking can. This song is called The King, motherfuckers. Hold your spots!
Somebody scream! Can't you see the walls inside your eyes?
you guys doing? How we doing? They like it. We got anybody coming to the house? Did people came to the show today with a loved one, a friend, your homie, your roommate, boyfriend, girlfriend? Sisters, ex-boyfriends, cousins, former roommates. Anybody seen Spaceballs? Hey, if you came to the show with something that you love, do me a favor right now. Take a moment and give him a fucking hug and tell him you love him right now. Seriously. Anybody not get a hug? Hey, do me a favor. See these three people right here? Y'all hug each other right now. Everybody hug it out. Hug it out. Hugs for thugs. Hugs are better than drugs. What? What? Your husband isn't Kosovo? Yeah, what's his name? Kyle? What is he doing in Kosovo? Okay, what's his last name?
What?
Kyle Rizkaza. West Kaza? Kyle West Kaza. Be safe. Press Kaza. Well, I'm partially deaf. Kyle Press Kaza. I'm Tommy Vexed. On behalf of everybody who's still back home, thank you for your fucking service. We appreciate you. Happy Veterans Day. We're gonna play some more songs. This is a song about family, and I found my family fucking, God, just fucking jamming out, playing shows. I was a runaway kid. I've been fucking playing shows since I was 13 years old. Grew up in CBGBs, fucking doing all kinds of shit. And I'll tell you this, in the fucking, you know, I've been in death metal bands and punk rock bands and metalcore bands and all kind of bands and rock bands, and you sold out and played a cover song band. And I'll tell you this, like, it's hard to convince somebody like me that fucking racism is a problem in America when I've been playing rock music to people of all races and all colors, all creeds, all across this country. And nobody ever had a problem with the color of my skin, ever. So I appreciate you guys not fucking, you know, I appreciate everyone who knows that this narrative they're pushing on fucking TV and social media is bullshit. Ladies and gentlemen, this song's called Remember When. Sing along if you know the words. Appreciate to you. motherfuckers. Invite. Sing it! What'd you say, Miss Sugar? What'd you say, Lisa Turtle? Oh, take your shirt off. Not half bad. What happened? Just sexual harassment. What do you guys think about Kyle Rittenhouse? Oh man. You saw that fucking prosecuting attorney the other day? They fucking tried so hard. First they're like, he's a white supremacist. Kyle's fucking Hispanic. You know what I mean? My favorite is the fucking mixed race white supremacy, which means anybody of color who doesn't believe they're a victim and wants to take personal responsibility for their lives and win in America is a non-white white supremacist. It's ridiculous. And this motherfucker, they put this motherfucker on trial for murder when he acted in self-defense. And the star witness, this Antifa pussy cunt piece of shit. He has the face that you would fuck in prison. You would smash his eye out so you could fuck his eye socket to show him what a fucking pussy ass bitch he is. This motherfucker goes on the stand and the judge and the fucking, and the... And they're like, did you point the gun directly at Mr. Rittenhouse before he fired on you? No. Yeah, so? It's self-defense, nigga. Your whole case is shot. And also, I find it ironic. Now listen, it is fucked up that a minor has to feel the need to fucking strap up with a firearm to protect his neighborhood with all the fucking bullshit that was going on in 2020. And if you're a minor and you're on the show, please don't fucking do that. However, if you're gonna be underage and you're gonna get a firearm and you're gonna kill somebody, for the love of God, please make it another pedophile. What are the fucking odds? What are the odds? These motherfuckers are trying to put this 16-year-old kid in jail for murder, and he fucking did a service to the community by killing a fucking pedophile. Can't make this shit up, folks. Well, I didn't write this song, but I like it a lot. This song's called Hollywood's Bleeding. Also, fuck Travis Scott. Hollywood's bleeding, empires bleeding, dark news turns to train home. Dying in a sleep, we're living out a dream. We only make it out alone. I just keep on hoping that you call me. You say you want to see me, but you never took the time to get to know me. We're scared of losing something that we never found. We're running out of reasons, but we can't let go. Couples that came to the show tonight, put your fucking hands up. I can't see y'all. Oh, wow. This is a city of love. I like that. Oh, listen. Have your husband see me after the show, ma'am. Girl needs discipline. Now, listen, if you came to the show with your fucking partner, I want to know who bought the tickets. Who? You bought them? You bought the tickets? Now listen, whoever paid for the tickets tonight, when y'all go home, the person who got the free concert, you gotta go down on the other person. Them's the rules. So, Zach, you turn these fucking lights down off me. There's no need for it to be this bright. We're gonna play a love song for y'all. I just spoke to my man Jelly Roll. And, I recorded this song last year. I'm putting out a covers album, right? Just I did this shit for shits and giggles while I was in the studio last year during quarantine. And I sent it to my boy, and he blessed me with some vocals. So this is going to be a duet with me and my man. So, ladies and gentlemen, get a little closer and sing along to some Tennessee whiskey. Spend my nights out on the ballroom. That's right. Liquor was the only love I'd ever known. But you rescued me from reaching the bottom. Nobody sing better than Chris Stapleton. That song's so good it made my pussy win. I don't even have one. Hey, how many of you motherfuckers getting fucked up tonight? Is anybody in the house not getting fucked up and having a great goddamn time? We got anybody that's sober in the motherfucking audience? Where are all my people in recovery? People got time in recovery, huh? Okay, we got two over. Hey, how much time do you got, baby? 2.5 years sober. Make some fucking noise. What about you? 3.5. Oh, she got you beat. Make some noise. My man right here. 5 years sober? Fuck you. Half a decade without a fucking drink or a drug. My man. 4 years. Woo! 4 fucking years. We got 6 years right behind you right there. 9 fucking years! You got 10! 9 and 10! Back there. What? Never stop. He's like, I'll never quit. That's cool. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, as today, by the grace of God, the book, the steps, the fellowship, the whole package deal, I get to say that I am 12 years sober and I'm fucking loving life. And
Now, if you're not, that's cool. And if you don't fucking relate to that, I know that everybody in here has either loved someone, worked with someone, had a friend. We've all known somebody in our lives that have struggled with addiction, alcoholism, mental health disorders, all of these things, right? These are diseases that they affect everyone whose life touches the sufferer. And I want you to know that this life thing that we do it together. And so whatever you got going on, I want you to stay close to your friends, close to your family, and call somebody if you need help, man. There's no fucking shame in reaching out and asking for help. We need each other. I need y'all to get through this life. I wrote a song about it, and this song's called Sober. Feel that one. Feel that one. That's fucking heavy, bro. It's sometimes like the heaviest songs are the lightest songs. That's, you know, they don't like, you just fucking tell the fucking, that's some Bob Dylan shit, you know what I mean? Gets you thinking about life, you know? Well, I appreciate you, brother. Thanks for being here. How we doing? Anybody who's never fucking come to see Tommy Vex or any band I've ever been in, you guys doing okay? Okay, I appreciate you. Thanks for sticking around and not throwing lettuce at me or any of that shit.
Who's this guy? Fuck this guy.
You know what I mean? I love you guys too. Hey, anybody know about a time that I sang for a band called Five Finger Death Punch? Yeah. Wild shit, man. Wild shit. Fucking 2017 out in Europe. My man Ivan Moody was having some serious problems. Had to go to the hospital and fucking deal with his shit, and they asked me to fill in for them. And it was an honor and a privilege, and I got to play festival shows in Europe with hundreds of thousands of people, and with some people I really respect. And one of the people that I met in Madrid was a guy named Chester Bennington from a band called Linkin Park. And I was fucking, ooh, fuck. This dude came up to me and was like, hey man, how's it going? And I'm like, started sweating. I was like Chris Farley interviewing Paul McCartney. I was like, do you remember the time when we were Meteora? I'm fucking like, yo, chill, be cool. Be cool, big brother, be cool. Anyway, I didn't know what to say, like, and I was just like, I don't know. Yeah, how you doing, bro? I don't know. And he looked at me, and I'll never forget, this man had so much kindness in his eyes. And he said, don't forget to have fun. And, you know, and then after that tour a few weeks later, I found out, like everybody else, that Chester had taken his life. And, you know, the reason why I talk about this story is because I'm an attempted suicide survivor. And it's important that we know that we never know what the person next to us in a crowd or on the street or online is going through. And sometimes we can be fucking assholes to each other on the computer. We gotta chill out with that shit, man. You know, I just saw the Dave fucking Chappelle special. His friend who is transgender got bullied till she committed suicide. We don't know what fucking people are going through, man. And I wanna let you know that for whatever reason, if you're going through a fucking rough time and you're in that dark place and you might think that it might be better if you weren't here, I'm here to tell you that it's not gonna be better without you here. And that I need you to fucking be here with me today to get through this fucking shit that's going on in this world, because we're in a spiritual fucking war and we need as many good-hearted, kind people. And that's who this shit affects the most. The people who want to do the best that they can and they keep getting fucking pushed down and kicked while they're down by life. But I'm here to tell you that when we get together, we kick back, okay? And there's no shame in getting help, and that your life, if you take your own life, you'd be killing the wrong person, because you don't know who you're going to become when you get on the other side of the shit that you think is impossible. Because all of us here are completely capable of overcoming impossible odds. And I want to say thank you to Chester for inspiring me. And I'm going to send this one out to him. Ladies and gentlemen, this song's called Crawling. Confused. inside my own reflection. It's haunting how I can't seem to find myself again. My walls are closing in without a sense of confidence, and I'm coming dead.
Thank you. Can come let me up. I'm about to hit up a block away. Come let me up.
Yeah. For sure. I want to thank everybody who fucking supported me this year. You guys know the cancel culture came after your boy Tommy Vex pretty hard. They fucking got kicked off my label because I voted for Trump. My fucking band tried to throw me out of my own company, even though these motherfuckers don't write any of the songs or record any of the Bad Wolves music. It's like kicking Trent Reznor out of Nine Inch Nails. And the new album is just fucking garbage as a result. But I'm not, you know, I'm just, you know, I was gonna change my name to Tom Petty, but it was taken. Yeah, I love those first week fucking sales numbers though. My last record came in at number 2. These niggas couldn't break 200. That's the problem. The problem with Hollywood is they want to fucking control what you think. They don't give a fuck about you. All these CEOs and these fucking millionaires, and they want to control culture. And historically, yeah, fuck them. No, seriously. The only good pedophile is a dead pedophile. Seriously. That's why they're trying so hard to normalize this shit, bro. These motherfuckers, you got fucking, you know, dog killing ass Fauci and all this bullshit out here. Fucking trying to get a, they got Sesame Street, bro. My niggas got Sesame Street. I'm like, Elmo, blink twice if you need help. Big Bird, fucking Big Bird. My heart broke. I was like, Big Bird, holy shit, this nigga's on drugs. The fucking count, the count. D stands for death. Ha, ha, ha. M stands for microchondritis. Ha ha ha. Cookie Monster's eating vegetables. What the fuck's going on? I'm sick of this shit. Oh, it's enough to drive a person crazy. We got time for one more. Ladies and gentlemen, please make some noise for my friends in Achilles Confession. Make some noise for Caitlin Curtis. And my brother from another mother, the realest motherfucker. Ladies and gentlemen, make some goddamn noise for Struggle Jennings out of this motherfucker. All right. This song is going out to Dolores O'Riordan of the Cranberries, God rest her soul. Every single one of you that bought this song, you made this the biggest fucking rock song to come out in 15 fucking years. And you gave me an opportunity to donate 100% of the proceeds to her children, because it was the right fucking thing to do. And that's what this shit is about. That's what we do. We do the fucking right thing around here. And we support each other and we cover each other's ass. And I fucking am so grateful to be a part of this community. And thank you guys for allowing us to come on this stage. This is your fucking house tonight. As far as I'm concerned, when you buy a ticket for a concert, you're renting the fucking building. We're all a bunch of assholes making noise in a room if it wasn't for everyone who came out and paid for fucking concert tickets and bought t-shirts and supported Patriot artists who they're trying to shut us down on social media and kick us off the radio because they don't want us to fucking, they know that we represent the voice of you and they're trying to silence all of us and we will not go quietly into the fucking night. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, this song is called Zombie. It's about to be that time again. No.
America, and fuck Joe Biden!